Welcome to Breakthrough. Thank you for joining us. Be sure to click the subscribe button followed by the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos.
Hi, Rockford. It's good to see you. We wanted to come together with you. Usually at this time, every Tuesday, we get together for prayer. And at the beginning of prayer, I always like to just kind of give you something to think about when we get ready to go into prayer. Prayer is a very important ingredient, I think, in all of our lives. I think sometimes we confuse prayer with our ability to complain to God about things. And because really, it's about a relationship, isn't it, with God? And it's funny that if we were really to balance out our relationship with God, I think we should really look at how we treat others and begin to think about, you know, is this the way I treat God? Or, you know, and my expectation of how God is really based sometimes on some flawed view of my own life experience. And really, it's not like that at all. And so I want to just kind of talk to you for just a minute. And I want to look at a little story, a little encounter with someone you're probably familiar with. It's a story that we're all really very well aware of. And it's found in Exodus, the third chapter, where Moses was tending his, he was a son-in-law, and he was tending his father-in-law's sheep out in the middle of a desert somewhere. And there was this bush that was burning, that was not being consumed. And he's like, I got to go see what this is all about. So he turns aside to go and look at this phenomenal event that was happening. And he turned aside and he went there. And the scripture says that at the moment Moses turned, God was watching him. And God was watching for Moses to turn and look. And I wonder sometimes if this isn't part of the part of what's happening in our life all over the world, actually. We have this great event that causes us all to slow down, to stop, and to take a look. And this is exactly what was happening in the life of Moses. And he turned to look, and at that moment, he had an encounter with God. Actually, if you really look at that encounter and just dig in a little bit, I won't go too deep with you, but God said to Moses, he said, take off your shoes. Take the thing that you're standing on, get them things off, and let's have a conversation. Let's have a moment together. And isn't that really a great principle to think about? When we go to God and pray, we have to come into a different position or a different posture. We have to begin to change what we're standing on, right? And be willing to be transformed in this time with God, this encounter with God, this relationship with God. So very important. You know, I always love that encounter, because Moses actually makes God angry in the encounter, because Moses got all these excuses, and I don't know, maybe this, let me just say a couple of them. He says, God, I'm not qualified. So here is Moses telling God what he can and can't do, when God is the creator who created Moses, and Moses is the creation. And God even says to him, he says, did I not make you? Am I not the one who created the tongue? And he says stuff like that to Moses. And I find it amusing, but the only reason why I find it amusing is because that's me. I'm the same. I have that same attitude with God sometimes, because I want to tell him what to do and how to do it and what it should look like. And maybe that's just me. And then he says, I'm not a good public speaker. I can't speak. Nobody's going to listen to me. And nobody will believe me, he goes on to say. And I don't have the answers. And I'm just not good enough. And all of those little excuses, okay, are all answered when we come to a place where we really understand that we don't have the answer. We really don't understand. We really are not able. And isn't that the very reason that we need God in the first place? And I think if you were honest with yourself right there in that moment, you would understand and maybe even feel the presence of God right there and say, you know what? This is the moment. this is the time where I'm going to allow God to change my life. I'm going to allow God to work through me in a different way. I'm going to take off my shoes, okay? I'm going to take off the platforms that I'm standing on. I'm going to take off I'm going to get rid of my position, and I'm going to allow God to establish me. And so I just love that thought, and I just want to pray today with you just for a moment. I'm not trying to take up a lot of your time, but I really want to challenge you to you know, maybe just change your posture when you pray. You know, that's set the time aside. Maybe turn on a little music or whatever it is that you have to do to set an atmosphere of worship. Let's let God be God. Amen. Let's get on our knees again. I think it's so critical that we get on our knees. It's a sign that I have humbled myself. It's a sign that I'm no longer going to use an excuse. I'm going to take time. I'm going to keep my appointment with God today. And so let's just pray together just for a minute. I'm going to pray a little bit, and I hope that you will pray with us as well. And not just today, not just for 5 minutes, but make it a habit. Make it an everyday event in your life and in your relationship with God. So let's just pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we just thank you right now for this relationship that we have with you. We thank you, Lord, that you are God, that you are in control, that you are the creator, that you're the one that made heaven and earth. We thank you, Father, Lord, that you love us with a love so great that you sent your Son to die for us, and we just worship you. And we give you praise and glory. And Lord, we ask right now that you would come and touch our land, touch the leadership, from the president to the governors to the mayors to Congress and the Senate. Lord, we give all of these leaders to you right now. And Lord, we ask, Lord, that you give them wisdom, give them courage, give them strength. Lord, guide their path, guide their decision making. And Lord, help us, even us right now, that we would be transformed through all of this, and Lord, that we would become a nation that has recentered and refocused itself, Lord. Lord, help us not to focus on division, Lord, and things that divide us, but rather focus on you, Lord, that we, the church, would grow and become who you've called us to be, that we would be true salt, that we would be the flavor of the world, Lord, that we would, through each of us, Lord, we are the church. So, Lord, I ask for your anointing to come, and to transform each one of us, Lord, in each circumstance, in each situation, Lord, in our families, Lord, in our thinking, Lord, in our heart, in our mind, Lord, that we can begin to live out, Lord, what you have so freely given to us, Lord, which is just love. And Lord, we just thank you for that. We worship you. We give you praise. We give you glory. And we give you honor. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. And we look forward to connecting with you. If you could go to mybreakthrough.online, you'll find our homepage, and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. You could like us on Facebook. I think we're on Twitter and Instagram. But we would love to partner with you. We would like to become part of your daily life. And also, not just a relationship with you personally, but where we could all come together, whether it's on the internet or even after this is over. We'd love for you to become part of our congregation right here in Rockford, Illinois. God will use us, each of us, to do something powerful in the world around us. Amen. Because we are in the world, but not of the world. Amen. Amen. That's all because of a relationship with Him. We love you. God bless you. Have a great evening.